Hello everyone, my name is Taruna and I'm a marketer at Visual Website Optimizer. My core role here involves SEM and I've also handled many customer case studies and I've gone through hundreds of conversion optimization tests of our customers. The agenda of today's webinar is to learn how we can improve our landing page performance with proper analysis. For this, we ask you guys to submit your landing pages along with the results from Landing Page Analyzer. We'll be taking four of them today. I'll be evaluating two and then my colleague Anand will take over and evaluate the other two. An important note, this webinar is being recorded and we'll send you the recording in a few days. So I'll begin with the evaluations. Firstly, let me give you a quick introduction of what Landing Page Analyzer is. We developed Landing Page Analyzer or LPA to become the starting point of your conversion rate optimization experiments. It is essentially a tool to help you evaluate your pages. So let me quickly begin by showing you how it works. So we'll open Landing Page Analyzer. It's up on my screen right now. It will then ask you to enter your details. And once you enter your details and let's get started, you will be asked 21 questions about your landing page. You'll get results marking your page on 5 different parameters, namely focus on goal, motivation, persuasiveness, propensity to take action, and relevance. I'll now begin with evaluating the first page and show you how I use the LPA's results to find out what it is on my page that I could possibly improve. Meanwhile, if you want to say hi to Anand or me or have any particular questions regarding the webinar or want us to help you optimize your pages, you can tweet to us at VWO with hashtag VWOLPA. I'll repeat that. Use hashtag VWOLPA to talk to us on Twitter. So let's get started with the first page. So the first page I'm evaluating is right here on my browser screen. It's ellawalkinbaths.com. This is their homepage. And along with this, they also submitted us their LPA score, which is a decent 65%. So now we'll see how this page can be improved. The first thing I'll do is quickly scroll down and see if I can find out the goal of the page. The purpose of its existence in a single line. So I see one big green CTA that says request a quote with a form, which means the page's goal is essentially a contact us to request for a quote on the walk-in baths. Even though I'm not a primary believer of above the fold theory, but here in this case, if I give a 2-second look to the page as soon as I open it, the first thing that catches my attention is financing available, and I'm like, okay, why is this so expensive? And there's a star mark along, which usually means that TNCs apply, which is a red flag for me. We'll come back to this again, but for now, in the 2-second test, I don't know what this website wants me to do. Maybe watch this video, but why? A proper headline telling me what it is that is at offer is missing. I may be at office or without headphones or over a choppy internet. What if I can't play the video? What is in for me? Clearly, a headline explaining what this is all about and why should I care is missing. This leads to a very low persuasion, and we can see that in our LPA score as well of just 40%. Here, I also suggest you to test the video against the image. Another thing, I just mentioned that the goal of the page is to collect leads. I can't buy this walk-in bath right away from here or anything else. So the sole purpose this page exists is so that visitors can contact the company. Now, if you see on top right, there are valuable elements, a phone number and an email address, which are absolutely in line with my goal. But hey, they aren't as highlighted as required either, because if your goal is just to make people talk to you, all possible mediums should be equally highlighted. So as important, or I would say even more important than the form, is the phone number and the email field. So I can just pick up the phone, dial you guys, and know what is it and how much it costs. Also, it makes sense to keep it in a fixed top bar. So while I'm scrolling down and going through your awesome features, and in between I decide to call you guys, I should see the phone number there and then. The key is to make your users do very, very less work. The second thing that I'll add is that the features copy. or these 4 points. Here could be more to the point. I mean, the first point sounds vague to me. How does your product help me maintain my independence? Also, the last point, limited lifetime warranty. The words limited and lifetime together don't go very well. You could be more specific here. Let's scroll down a bit now to the form. So the forms. Forms stand first in my list of potential improvement areas. The CTA color is okay. I mean, it stands out pretty well. A better choice though would have been orange, as it is diametrically opposite to blue in the color wheel, creating perfect contrast. And in this case, for some browsers or for some colorblind people, a perfect contrast might not be created, as green and blue are quite near to each other on the color wheel. So in a form, the idea is to ask only what is absolutely necessary. Since I see you have a star marked on the phone field but not on the email field, you want to talk to people over the phone. I suppose the comments could be collected over the phone, and even the zip code for that matter. Now, I'm not sure what is absolutely important for you here, but you definitely should test removing the very big comments box here. Right now, it just visually gives me a feeling that the form is quite big. Also, I see that since the basic purpose of this form is to collect leads, either a phone number or email should do. Maybe you should keep one field and label it as an email or phone number. Now again, I'll suggest you should test this, but one thing you should absolutely necessarily test right away is make the form visually smaller and maybe shift it up below the features in a vertical manner, or if you want to do it horizontal, at the exact same place where right now this financing available shows. So let me scroll down a bit again. Now, award winning. This is something really exciting, but hasn't been properly used. Maybe just use the logos in a more visible place above the fold. A potential area right now seems to be the top left blue area, this right here, which is being wasted right now. Remove the text here. No one's very interested in reading which organization gave you this. Maybe link it to their homepage to create context, but this definitely deserves better treatment and more eyeballs. Now, just below it, the 4 points. Internet readers will usually skim and not go through paragraphs of text. So here you could add visuals to show what is a 360-degree swivel tray exactly, or how do these stainless steel and glass doors look. So we just saw that there's a lot that can be improved here, and the people from Ella Walk and Baths, if you guys listening and need any further clarification on any of the points I mentioned, you guys have my email, and I'm also available at Twitter at TARUNA2309 in case you want to say hello. Please do add hashtag VWOLPA along. Okay, so now I'll take up the next page. My next page is massageio.de. I'll begin with giving a high five for the bright red CTA here. It stands out pretty well, and in 2 second test, I know why I'm on this page. That is to find a massage. Now I'll come to the areas of improvement. The first thing, the headline. Even though it tells me quite well what it is that they are offering, but because of the picture in the background, the text does not stand out well. I tried increasing the font weight and it instantly made the headline look better and it stood out. So you can compare. And another thing, right now you'll see that the text on the lower CTA, this looks broken because there's an arrow pointing downward which becomes visible if we hover over it. This is a small design change, but if they adjust the positions properly, the text will become clearer. Now, like I said, every page has a reason for existence. Why Google is a thriving business and Yahoo couldn't make it to the top is clear on their home pages. Google knows what it wants you to do, and in case of Yahoo, well, no one does. So now coming back to this page, the reason for this page's existence is so that you can find a massage near you. The CTA button just below the search, big search bar, acts as a distraction here. What it does is that it takes users to a different page explaining how the booking process works, which in my view is not needed at this stage. Also, it is also present in the header. Now, let me scroll down a bit. Here, I see four different logos. And I'm not sure what is the context here. See these four logos. Are there some customers, or there awards or associations, and why are they here? For me, they're just taking up some important real estate and confusing me. Maybe the natives understand this and can make a quick connect, so I won't add further comments in it. So let me go down a bit. Another thing, they could test, these people could test, is these images that they've used for the features below. Right now, they look pretty much general and could be swapped with each other, which shouldn't be the case if you're using pictures conveying exactly what the feature below is trying to say. So maybe a hero shot of the feature is missing here. Good thing about the page is that there's a fixed top bar. So if at any point I decided to book a massage, a red CTA is always there on the screen. The last thing I want to add is that these three prices here are presented in a manner that they look clickable when they're actually not. A quick book your massage button right here along with these prices should add to the persuasion factor a lot. So that's all from my side. Do remember to tell me your views or say a hello to me on Twitter at Taruna2309. That's Taruna2309. Please use the hashtag VWOLPA. Now my colleague Anand will take over and evaluate two more pages for you guys. Thanks a lot.
Hello guys, thank you Taruna, that was some really great insight, and I hope the listeners have got some really good ideas which they can test on their own landing pages. So the next page that we're going to test is Transmission Repair Pros. It's a Milwaukee based company, and it deals in transmission rebuilds, repairs and replacements for Milwaukee. So the first thing that I noticed in this page is that it is not mobile responsive. I checked it on my cell phone, and it's really really difficult to zoom in, zoom out, and read the text. So this is one thing which I feel is really important in today's landscape, is that your website should be mobile responsive. Now I'm not sure how much of their traffic is coming in from mobiles and tablets. Maybe they should look into their Google Analytics data for that. Just my basic assumption that not making a website mobile responsive just eliminates an entire channel through which your audience can reach you. So this is one thing which I really feel that the transmission repair pros guys should look at, is making their website mobile responsive. So I'll just pull this page up on Awesome Screenshot so that I can show you which areas I want to target. Another thing which I noticed in this is the really poor color scheme in the top bar. I think you can see where my mouse is pointing at. This top bar has really poor color scheme. Unfortunately, deep red background and black text don't really go together very much. So since this is probably a very important area in this page, I'm sure that it has a lot of scope for improvement. So I suggest that you guys look into the color wheel, which can be easily accessed from Google, from a simple Google search, and just make sure that the background and the text go well in terms of contrast, and the users do not have to strain their eyes when they are trying to read the text. Looking more detailed way into the top bar, I see the contact number here. Yeah. So this, I'm assuming that this contact number is one of the main CTAs of this page, in that they want people to call us on their number, since this number has been mentioned multiple times throughout the page. So this is actually good that they have a phone number right at the very outset, and it's important to display a phone number for these kind of local businesses which cater to a local clientele, since it helps in building trust towards a business at the very outset. If they have any doubt, they can just call you up at that very moment and resolve all their doubts. So I feel that since this is a very important piece of information, what I would suggest here is that increase the size of this top bar. Make it bigger. This is my suggestion. Obviously change the color and increase the font weight and the font size of the contact number. This contact number should be made much bigger, and it should be made much more prominent. So that would be a really great option here. Another thing which I saw in this top bar is this search box. Now I'm not sure how many of you guys can see this search button. Yeah, here the search button. It's very faintly visible on my screen, again due to the very poor color scheme. But apart from that, I'm not sure how many people use this search bar. I tried searching for transmission and nothing came up. So I'm guessing that the search function doesn't work very well. And right now it is consuming prime real estate in the page. So maybe they should consider replacing that with something more valuable, like a CTA or like a link to a form, which would serve their business goals much better, in my opinion. So after that, I look at the navigation panel here, at the navigation bar rather. Yeah, this one. To me, it looks kind of broken because the contact us button is coming below the other button. So it just looks very, very odd, and it looks kind of broken. So in fact, what I would do here is make this entire section into one whole. So that all the information, the logo, the navigation panels, and the contact number can be presented in a much more compact and aesthetically pleasing way. So that's it for the navigation panel and the top bar. Another thing which I noticed as I was scrolling down this page is that the contact number has been mentioned too many times. It's here, it's here. So I didn't count how many times it's been mentioned, but I think it was something around 7 or 8 times, which is too much in my opinion. I get that this contact number is an important objective of the page, but mentioning it again and again doesn't really help in my opinion. Instead, a better option would be to place it bigger, as I mentioned in the previous point. Make it more prominent in the top bar, and make the top bar floating, so that the users can see the top bar at whatever position of the page they are in. Even here they may be able to see the top bar. So what that would do is that save precious space on a landing page, as well as keep that contact number at the top of people's mind at all times on this page. So I guess that would do the trick here, instead of mentioning it again and again. Then I went to the main meat of the page, and I see the words free and free here. Now these two words have different styling. I don't know why. One is underlined and the other is not. So maybe it just looks kind of odd. So maybe they should really fix that. And more importantly, as we have seen multiple times when we are dealing with clients in VWO, is that the word free really works in increasing conversions. I know it's kind of overused, but it works. I mean, we have seen it in multiple case studies. You can check out our case studies on our website, and you'll find a lot of instances where just adding the word free increased conversions. So maybe what I would do here is that highlight these two words more, maybe by putting it in a different styling, in a different font, increasing the style. I mean, just making it more prominent so that it is one of the first things that the user notices on the page. It's just a simple CSS change, but I feel that it could really bump up your conversions a little bit. Okay, so this caught my attention here in a bad way. So this looks like a button, looks like a standard CTA button, in fact, but it is actually not clickable. If you go to the actual page, there is no it's not clickable. It's just another this thing. It's not clickable. So yeah, I mean, I think the page would be much better served if this was replaced by the form, by the contact us form, which is there at the bottom of the page or below this section. Since the contact number, as we discussed, has already been mentioned in the top bar and the navigation panel, this space could be used for the form. It has a video. This page has a video above the fold, which I'm personally not very fond of. For three reasons. First, the user might not have audio on the device on which he's accessing your page. Secondly, he might be in an office environment, so he may not be able to access your video. Thirdly, he may be working with a choppy internet, which may not be able to access your video, which may not be able to play your video. And if any of these three situations arise, you've lost a potential good customer. So I feel that video above the fold is generally not a very good idea, and it is not a substitute for content. Instead, what I would do here is that test this against a simple hero image of one of your employees in a company t-shirt or something. In my opinion, that would give your page a much higher degree of trust factor and also just improve the overall user experience of the page. So that's it for the video. As I was scrolling down the page, I saw various headlines. You can see these headlines. This one. Yeah. So there are many headlines like these, but they're not being emphasized apart from simply bolding it. Now, what I would do here is that emphasize these headlines first. Because one thing we need to understand is that very few people will be able to take in all this information at one go. Headlines really help for the users to quickly gauge what the entire content is all about, and then they can pick and choose the content which they want to read or the content which they feel is more useful for them. So one thing I would definitely emphasize the headlines more, make them larger. Something like this. This one is larger. So something in this styling maybe would work. And I see some images here. Now I'm not sure whether these are stock images or whether they're actual images from your business. But the thing is that they look like stock images. Now stock images generally display not a very good image for your business, since a stock image automatically gives a perception that the business is not a genuine one. So what I would do here is that replace these apparently stock images with images of your employees and photos of your garage and repair center. I think that would really help in increasing the trust factor and building it. Thirdly, I see that some of the points are written in bullet point format, while some are written in a paragraph format. I would suggest replacing all the paragraph based content into bullet shaped content, since bullet points really help to concise down the information and make it much more tighter. The thing is that there is too much text here. I mean, it almost reads like an essay. The thing we need to understand here is that users online make judgments really quickly. So I would actually rework this entire content from here till here and make it more focused on headlines, hero images, which are images of your company, and bullet points, short, crisp bullet points. I think that would do the trick here. Another thing that I noticed in this page is that there is absolutely no social proof in this page. I don't see any testimonials from your customers. Now, it is very difficult to have trust in this page if no one is vouching for you, especially since it's a local based business. I think it's a great opportunity for you guys that you can take testimonials from some of your customers together with attribution and a photo of the person who's giving the testimonial. I think even one testimonial like that would really build up the trust factor of this page manifold. So that's about the trust factor. Now let's come to the form. Yeah, let me just zoom out my screen so that you can see the entire form. Yeah, I am not very happy with the title of this form. The title of this form is "Would you rather have us call you?" I think it could be improved and tightened. Instead of a question here, something like "fill up this form and we'll get in touch with you within 12 hours." Now I'm assuming, so in my understanding that in the transmission repairs business, speed plays a big role. Because if the transmission of your vehicle has been compromised, you want to get it done as quickly as possible. You want to get it sorted out, and you don't want to contact someone who will come next week or after 3 or 4 days. You want to get it done, preferably on the same day. So just adding a time commitment here, like "we'll get in touch with you within 12 hours," can really help build a trust factor in the business. Of course, when you're doing this, it's also important that you're actually able to follow through on the time commitment which you are giving. So that is one thing which should be considered here before giving a time commitment. Let me zoom out of this page. Yeah. Now, as I look at the form more closely, I see this message form field, and below the form it is written, "Make sure to let us know in the message box when is the best time to reach you." So, just give me 1 second. Yeah, this for this. "Make sure to let us know in the message box when is the best time to reach you." So this is the purpose of the message box, that the users will tell you that what time you should call them up. Now, in our experience, when we are optimizing landing pages and forms, the message form field is usually ignored. If you want the message box to serve a specific function, like in this case, it would be much better to replace the message form field with something more specific, like a drop down to select the time. I think that would result in much more conversions. So that is one thing that the transmission repair pros guys should really check out. Another thing I noticed was the capture box. Yeah, this one. It looks really outdated, and in fact the captcha is actually really bad user experience, because it asks for too much effort on the part of the user. You may be losing out valuable customers if someone is not able to decipher these characters and just closes the page instead of trying again. So you've lost one valuable customer in that way. So I think that captcha is not a good idea, and instead try asking a very simple addition question, like 2 + 3 = ? Asking people for a simple simple math question, and with a form field like "prove that you're human," "prove that you're human" or something. So I think that would really benefit this page. So I guess that's it for on this page. Now we'll go to the next page. In the meantime, I would just like to reiterate that if you have any questions regarding this webinar or anything that you want to chat on, just contact us on Twitter. Our Twitter handle is twitter.com/VWO. Yeah. And if you want anything specific to this webinar, just reply with the hashtag. Just contact us with the hashtag VWOLPA. Yeah, so that's it on this page, Transmission Repairs Pros guys. Thank you guys for submitting this landing page. I think we got a ton of points that all of us can use in our landing pages. So the next page that we're going to look at is Home Loan Experts. As is self-explanatory from the headline, they provide home loans for people who don't have a lot of money in their bank account. So the first thing I noticed in this page is that it is mobile responsive. So I checked it on my mobile and it works perfectly well. So that is one positive right off the bat. So yeah, good job with that, Home Loan Experts guys. Another thing which caught my attention in this page as I was scrolling down is that the size of the top bar reduces in size as you scroll down the page. Now I've seen this in some other pages as well. I don't know what is the reason for this, but it just looks really jarring to me as a layman who is scrolling down a website. I feel a little off, and it looks unpolished. So I don't know what the reason for this is, but hopefully this could be tested out or considered. Now I like the fact that they have put their contact number here. In a very prominent font, in a very prominent position, as I mentioned in the previous page as well, giving your contact number adds a level of trust. The user has an option of calling you up straight away if he or she has any doubt. It would be great. So now this would be even better if this was a toll-free number, as it increases the trust factor even more. Also, you could add more info here to increase trust, like your email ID, your office address, etc. So yeah, so a good job here on the contact number positioning. Now I looked at the headline. No genuine savings, you can still get approved for a home loan. And this one, and the page title is No Genuine Savings, Home Loan Experts. Now, I feel that no genuine savings is not a very good terminology to be used in a headline. I think it gives a very negative connotation. I understand that the target audience that you're trying to reach are people who want to own a home but do not have a lot of savings in their bank account. But I think this could be expressed in a much better, much more neutral way, such as buy a home without investing anything or something like that. Accordingly, the page title should also be modified. So that's it on the headline. Now I was reading the text above the fold. We can help you borrow up 90% of the purchase price. We can help you borrow up to 95% of the purchase price. We can help you reduce the costs of completing the purchase. In my opinion, this text is very middle of the funnel. Middle of the funnel meaning terminology is for someone who already knows their stuff. So I think instead of being feature oriented, make it more benefit oriented here, such as own a home loan with just 90% own a home by paying just 10% upfront. I think that's a more benefit-oriented headline than this. And just add a hero image and a testimonial here. Maybe add the photo and a small comment from any of your existing customers, such as home loan experts really helped me buy this perfect home at a dirt cheap price, something like that, with a hero image of your customer. I think that would really benefit the above the fold section of this page. So yeah, that's it for the headline and the text here. Okay, now I looked at these CTAs. So I didn't like the fact that these two CTAs, find out if we qualify and I want to learn more, have the exact same styling. Now I'm assuming that the find out if you qualify CTA is the primary CTA of this page, since that is the one which leads to a form, and the other CTA, I want to learn more, leads to a how does it work section. So if find out if you qualify CTA is the primary CTA, I would suggest making it bigger and more prominent so as to clearly differentiate it from the secondary CTA. It is always a good idea when you're designing your CTAs to step 10 feet away from your screen and view the page. Can you clearly make out your primary CTA from 10 feet? If you can't, then it may be a good idea to work on your CTA styling and placement, since the CTA is the single most important element of your landing page. Basically, your entire landing page revolves around your CTA, and the basic objective of your landing page is to get people to click on the CTA. So that is one thing which should be very, very optimized. So yeah, I would suggest making find out if you qualify more prominent and really establish the hierarchy that this is the primary CTA and I want to learn more is a secondary CTA. So that's it on the CTA styling. Just give me a second, please. Yeah. Okay, another thing that I noticed in this page is that there are absolutely no images on this page. Absolutely none. Especially in the how does it work section, this section, or rather just let me show it on the awesome screenshot window. This section, how does it work, and this section, add lender's mortgage insurance to the loan. Now there's a lot of text in both these sections which may be difficult for the user to grasp. Yeah, in this text and this text, it's a lot of text and it's written in a kind of a technical way, so it may be difficult for the user to understand what it is all about. It has been proved time and again in multiple tests that visual cues really help people to understand the concepts much better than text. So adding a graphical representation in these two sections of what you're talking about will break the monotony of the page as well as help the user to understand what you're trying to say here. So yeah, this is my suggestion that add images, graphical representations, graphical explanation of this text. I think it would really benefit the conversion rate of this page. Okay, let's now go back to the top section of this page. Yeah. So when I clicked on the I want to learn more section, when I clicked on the I want to learn more CTA, yeah, this CTA, it took me to the how does it work section. So this is nice that there is a clear path of action for the user, and there is no confusion that clicking on that CTA really helps you understand what the business is all about. But the problem I felt was that after reading the how does it work section, after reading this section, if I want to sign up or ask for a quote, I have to scroll right down to the bottom of the page to fill up this form. It's not good user experience since you don't want your users to make an effort in locating your form. I mean, that's the basic objective of a landing page. So it would be interesting and beneficial, in my opinion, if we could add a CTA here in this section. Add a CTA just after the how does it work section, a CTA to the form at the bottom of the page, I would like to say, so that let's and just track how many people click on it. I think it would really benefit the conversion rate of this page. Yeah, let's go back to the top for some more data. Yeah, now if you click on find out if you qualify a CTA, it takes you to the bottom of the page. Now since this is the primary, one of the primary objectives of this page, to fill up this form, I would suggest to place it higher. I think it is now suboptimally placed. I mean, why do you want people to click on the CTA at the top and lead them to another form? Why not have the form at the top itself? So I think that could work. That is one thing. Another important thing which I saw, which I feel is a mistake here, is that the CTA says, find out if you qualify. Now if I click on this, the form title is get a free assessment now. Find out if you qualify versus get a free assessment now. I feel that there is a disconnect here between the CTA and text and the form title. Ideally, the CTA and the form title should have the same words, so that there is no scope for confusion. I admit I did feel a little confused if this was the right form, simply because of the CTA and the form saying two different things. So yeah, I mean, that is one suggestion, that have use the same terminology for both the CTA text and the form title text. Now let's look more closely at the form here. I was mostly okay with the form, except the CTA text. Okay is a CTA text. Now okay is a very, very generic word, doesn't really mean anything specific. I think it would be really beneficial if we could try replacing it with a more relevant message, like find out if you qualify or get started, something like that. More relevant CTA text would maybe increase the form fill rate of the speech. That's it for the form. Okay, so these are testimonials, which is good. The previous page didn't have them, but they have. So these guys have testimonials with proper attribution of the folks who have given the testimonials. So I think that is good. One thing that could be improved here is adding images to the testimonials. As I mentioned in the previous page as well, to build a level of trust that this CTA is genuine and not made up by the company, it's really important for users to have that level of trust, and adding the image of the person who has given the testimonial really builds up that trust. So yeah, that is one thing. Okay, I would suggest making this text here, adding lenders, mortgage, insurance, the explaining text here, make it bullet point. Since I see it is number based, and many of your users may not have expertise regarding this and may feel intimidated by all this paragraph text. So instead, give just two or three main bullet points with a link for more explanation, so that if anyone wants more explanation, he has got a link for it. So yeah, that is one thing here. Just let me see if there's anything else. So they have trust factors here, trust symbols here, which is good. So yeah, I guess that's it, guys, from my side. I think these two pages are really, really good examples of the improvements that could be made. So thank you, guys, home loan experts guys and transmission repair pros guys, for submitting these two landing pages. I hope you got some good insights from our analysis today. So that's it for the pages. In the meantime, if you have any questions, I would like to say that please reply to us at marketing@wingify.com, or if you have any questions regarding the VWO tool and how it fits into your how it can fit into your CRO methodology, just drop a mail to us and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. A short note about VWO. VWO is a A/B testing personalization platform for marketers. We have more than 3,700 customers, with including JustFab, Daffity, ShoeDazzle. Check out our website at VWO.com, or reach out to us on Twitter at twitter.com/VWO. Thank you, guys. It was really great giving this webinar. I'm sure, I hope you guys had good insights which you can use for your own landing pages. Thank you.